Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.3 and iOS 14.4 Beta 1 have been out for a few weeks. I've been using them primarily on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, the iPhone 11 that I have here, and the 12.9 iPad Pro from 2020. And so I want to talk about when you can expect the next updates, also what to expect them to fix, and talk about kind of what's going on with iOS 14.3, as a lot of you have voiced concerns about different bugs and asked if I've reported them to Apple and things like that. And so the first thing is iOS 14.3 came out on December 14th, and then 2 days later, iOS 14.4 Beta 1 came out to developers and public beta testers on the 16th. And so those particular versions were the last ones between the holiday break, where Apple usually takes a few weeks off and then resumes pushing out betas and software updates after that. And so we haven't had an update for quite some time, but this is completely normal year over year. And so the good thing is with 14.3, a lot of you are reporting that it's really good. Now there's a lot saying it isn't, but about 50% are having no issues whatsoever. I've seen that in over 45,000 votes on the community poll we'll take a look at in a little bit. And then also a lot of people are having good battery life. Now that's not everyone, and there's definitely some concerns with both 14.3 and 14.4 betas right now. But the first thing, like I said, is it seems to be stable for a lot of people. And if you're not someone that notices a lot of bugs or little issues, you probably won't have an issue. However, the main thing I notice with it is lag, and that goes across 14.3 to 14.4. It doesn't seem to fix this issue. And what I mean by that is when you open up, say, an app like music, or maybe you're just scrolling and then you go out of that, anytime you swipe up, sometimes there's a little lag or stutter when you do that. So you swipe out of something and occasionally it will go really slow. Almost, it's a jitter almost, like it drops frames or has a slow frame rate, and then it resumes normal speed after that. It's really hit or miss. It's hard to replicate, but it's definitely something that's happening. Another thing that I hear almost every day now is, how can I fix the headphone volume issue? Or are you experiencing that? Thankfully, I'm not, but I know exactly what you're talking about, and that's under settings, sound and haptics, and headphone safety. If you're using headphone safety, which is a nice feature if you've got headphones, you want to make sure they're not too loud all day long, so to protect your hearing and things like that, it's nice, but a lot of people don't have these options to actually turn that feature off. And so what's happening is when you're using anything from Bluetooth to Apple CarPlay, you're in your car, maybe it thinks something's too loud and it drops the volume and now you can't hear it. You can actually turn this off, but not everyone has these options. And I don't know if it's region-based or not. It seems to be that in the European Union, those countries seem to have no option to turn that off, and some others have no option to turn it off. So I'm not sure what that is. Hopefully they add that option back, or at least fix the issue, because it's a big problem, especially in the car for a lot of people. Now, the other major issue, especially on 14.3, is the lack of notifications coming in. So notifications are not showing up properly for a lot of people. That includes text messages and more, although Apple was supposed to fix this with iOS 14.3. And so I'm really hoping we see a small update soon to address that. And then the other thing too that I'm seeing is odd connectivity issues. So sometimes I'll go to Safari, for example, maybe I'll go to apple.com, scroll through, maybe tap on something like this iPad Air, and it won't load. Then I'll go to my settings, turn off Wi-Fi, it jumps over to cellular and it will load. And I've only seen this on my iPhone and sometimes on the iPad on this version. My Wi-Fi at home will be working fine on something else like my computer, but it won't work here until I do that procedure. So people are seeing it that way and in reverse as well. So maybe you're on LTE or 5G or one of those, it doesn't load, flip to Wi-Fi, go back and it works. Other people have complained of heating of the device, so maybe their iPhone 12 all the way down to the 6S Plus is getting too hot, much hotter than it normally would. I haven't really experienced much of that, but I'm not an intense user as far as games and things, so I haven't really experienced that unless I'm recording 4K video. Then it will heat up, but it will get warm. That's normal for most things, but it won't get hot to where you can't touch it. It will tell you if it overheats, but that's not a normal thing with normal use. And then, of course, there's that green tint issue on the iPhone 12. So I was not able to replicate this. I tried on every device. I thought maybe I saw it on the iPhone 12 Pro, but basically when you're on a dark screen at about 40 to 80% brightness, you can kind of see it where it has a green tint on the outside edges. And a lot of people are seeing this. Apple has said that they're going to fix it. They're still working on it. So I would expect a software update to be pushed out to fix that. They actually fixed it with the iPhone 11 Pro and 11 Pro Max series last year. They had the exact same thing. So they were able to fix that with a software update. I would expect the same with this. Now with the iPad, we've had some issues as well. I've been using the beta on this iPad, and if I go to settings and then I'll go to software update, you'll see it's 14.4, it's beta 1. And the main issue I've had is the same as the iPhones. I've had the lag, the stuttering, and also sometimes touch responsiveness. It just won't work. I'll be in YouTube trying to move something. It won't work. I'll have to force close it. And I've had to hard reset it a couple times as well. And then sometimes it loses keyboard connectivity. So it just won't work. Even though it's plugged in, the trackpad will work, but then the keys won't work, or I won't be able to type. It's kind of strange. And then I'll disconnect the keyboard, plug it back in, and then it works. Sometimes it doesn't, but a reboot always fixes it. Now, if you're having those issues, of course you want to submit them in feedback if you're on the beta, but I've seen these on the non-beta as well. So this is these problems carry across from iOS 14.3 to 14.4. Also, battery on the iPad, and I'll talk about the iPhone in a moment. Battery has not improved, even though I've wiped this device. I tried wiping it. I've used it for about a week after I restored it, and it hasn't fixed it. It's still not getting any decent battery life compared to what it used to. And so you'll see it was last charged to 100% at 9:36 a.m. this morning, and I've had about 2 hours of screen on time, almost an hour and 43 minutes of screen off time, and I'm at 65%. I'm getting about 6 hours of screen on time with my iPad, which is terrible considering I'm using it mostly for YouTube, mail, and messages. I'm not using it for a whole lot else, and it just seems to not get great battery life. Now, I'm someone that actually charges my phone overnight every single night, but if you don't do that, some people are complaining that there's a lot of drain just doing nothing. So even though they're not seeing backups being completed or anything like that, it's draining a lot, anywhere from 20 to 40%, depending on who you ask. Now, I would bet it's actually doing backups when it's draining like that, but it's really hard to say. And I usually just plug it in so it can do all of those backups. I set it on a wireless charger and MagSafe at this point and just let it do its thing and then have optimized battery charging on. But if you don't have that convenience or you don't have that ability or you don't want to, then you may see some of that drain. Again, I would expect Apple to patch this in the future. So there's a lot that they need to fix. And battery life, whether it be on iOS 14.3 or 14.4, is great for some, not great for others. So on my phone, I've had 14.4 for some time, as you can see here, and it still hasn't been great. So this is yesterday, and it hasn't been charged since. So you'll see 3 hours and 10 minutes of screen on time, almost 4 hours of screen off time. So I've used a little bit over 50%. If we were to double that, we would get 6 hours and 20 minutes and almost 8 hours of screen off time. And while that may be okay for some, it's not really what a 12 Pro Max should be getting. It should be getting 10 to 12 hours. And I'm only getting that using Twitter, sometimes Telegram, and not much else, messages and things like that. I'm not using any games or doing anything intensive. The only thing I would do that's intensive is use the camera, and this is not great battery life. So I would expect Apple to fix it in the future, like I said, but there's definitely something going on, and I think once we get to the final version of 14.4, it should be more optimized. Now, with that yellow display issue on the iPhone 12, I don't think that's really an issue. I think it's a matter of the phone having a warmer display, which is technically more accurate compared to previous generations. I could be wrong about that, but from what I've seen with display tests and things, even though it is a little bit more yellow or warmer, you can see that when you go to settings and turn off dark mode, even though it is a little bit more yellow and warmer, it's actually, I can show you next to the iPhone 11, for example, it's actually technically more accurate. When people measure it with calibration tools and things like that, they actually find that it's more accurate. And I guess that's really what you want, is accuracy, but there is definitely a difference between the two displays, as you can see here. So that may bother some people, of course. So we'll turn dark mode back on. And I did do a YouTube community poll 3 weeks ago, and it's got 45,000 votes, which is incredible. So we'll take a look at that in a moment. Now, as far as upcoming updates, well, I would expect something as soon as Monday or Tuesday. Now, Apple stopped signing iOS 14.2.1 and 14.2 the other day, which means you can no longer downgrade past iOS 14.3. They usually give you one or two versions that you can revert back to if you have issues or things like that. And when they shut those off, within the next week to 2 weeks, there's always an update. But based on the long lag that we've had, having updates, I would expect something as soon as this week, including a beta update as well. If we looked at last year, this upcoming week is the week that we got an update as well. So Monday, Tuesday, if they go to a weird schedule again, it could be later in the week, but expect something coming very soon, hopefully early in the week. And of course, I'll keep you updated with that as well. So other than that, quite a few of you responded to the community poll. We'll go into that quickly. Many of you have seen it, but you can see here there's 45,000 votes, which is just incredible. And then if we scroll down, you'll see a few different things from a few days ago where someone hesitated to download 14.3 when it was released. It says, I finally decided to download it, and it's been great, especially the battery life. The battery life is excellent. Performance is excellent too. I'm really impressed with the battery life and how great it is. Apple got this update right. Overall, I'm very happy with iOS 14.3. I'm an iPhone 11 Pro Max user, or they're on that 11 Pro Max. So that's really good. And like I said, you'll find tons of comments here. There's 1,000 comments. And as you scroll through these, and I've read many of these, at least half of them, as you scroll through these, you'll see good reports and then you'll see bad reports. So this is specific to iOS 14.3, where 60% are saying it's great. So that's a good sign, but it's not quite where we were with 13.7, for example. So we've got a little ways to go. I'll look through a couple more comments though. It's been great for me thus far. iPhone 12 Pro Max, Nick B. Cover said. And then let's go see a couple more here. So iPhone XR here, been great so far. After a few days, the battery life has improved from earlier iOS 14 versions. So quite a few good things, like I said. Let's see what else. Great, I think. Found no battery problem so far on my iPhone 11. Battery life was slightly improved. So you'll see quite a good sign from many people. But again, you're going to see about the same amount based on these polls. About 55% or so have said that battery is good, 45 not so much. So it varies very much between the different users. We'll look at one more. You'll see Chris Owen said, my iPad Pro 11 stopped recognizing my Magic Keyboard trackpad for a good several hours, and a reboot didn't fix it. iPhone 12 Pro Max seems stable right now. So similar issues to what I've experienced with my iPad Pro. I'm not sure what that is. A reboot did fix it, but I had to disconnect the keyboard. So there's something weird there. But so many good comments here. People with that green tint issue, as you can see here, green tint keeps on the screen. They went to Apple Store and there's no hardware problem. So just a quick thing on that update is Apple has informed its technicians, according to an internal email apparently, that not to replace the phones if you're having that issue with the green tint, because they're going to fix it with software. So I think we're going to see that hopefully as soon as this week, along with some security updates and more, maybe some new features as well, but we'll only know once they release it. And so that's it for iOS 14.3, 14.4, and hopefully we'll see beta 2. We did have up to, I think, beta 5 last year with 13.4, so it could be a while until we see a final version of that, but I would expect an update with 14.3.1 probably very soon. Thanks again for always checking out these videos. I really appreciate it and participating in those polls. I think it's really valuable to everyone to get all of that information. And if there's something more you'd like in follow-ups, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.